Okay, in this hands-on guide, I'm going to show you how to find the part out value of a set, upload that set to Bricklink, and find the average selling price. The first thing we need to do is install Brickstore from brickstore.dev. The website is fairly self-explanatory. There's a download link where you can find the various versions of Brickstore. There's also an installation instructions page, which gives you some more information if you're unsure how to install new software. There are also some tutorials that you can look at to give you some help. Once you've installed Brickstore, this is the main screen you'll see. First thing we're going to do is go to the settings page. This is where you change your language, your currency, and where you want any files saved. The interface you can leave as it is. The Bricklink tab allows you to link your Brickstore account to your Bricklink account. This is useful for some more advanced features. The toolbar section allows you to customize the toolbars you see, and the keyboard allows you to change the keyboard shortcuts. Now that we've set up Brickstore on our computer, we need to create a Bricklink account by going to bricklink.com. This is the process you follow. Create an account, you need your email address, a username, password, date of birth, country, and language. So I'll set mine up as if I'm in the UK. I'm from Hampshire, in case you can't tell. Email address, I'll just hide. It could be any email address. The username is going to be the name that people will see you as on Bricklink. So mine's the Brick Cruncher. Yours can be whatever you want to. Password needs to be secure. As you see, you've got the red triangle there. As soon as you meet the criteria, you get a green tick. Date of birth. As this isn't going to be a real account, it doesn't matter. I'm not going to actually sign up. Once complete, we'll click next. We need to read terms and conditions. Obviously, it's important when signing this sort of agreement that you take recognition of what you can and can't do. So again, click those. Once you've created the account, you can see your icon up there, my Bricklink. Bricklink will also send you a registration email so that you can finalize the account. And that's it, we have a Bricklink account. So for part three, we're now going to import the Tide Bomber set into Brickstore and identify the part out value. So we import and brick set inventory. Now we need to type in the number of the set, which in this case is 911613. And this should bring us a preview of the item. Condition is new. As we're importing a full pack, we don't need to worry about the other options on this screen, unless we're bringing in a used foil pack, and then we would choose used. Brickstore now links to Bricklink and downloads the inventory into this spreadsheet type layout. On the screen, we can see the parts and the part numbers. We can see that there are 13 lots and 26 items. Now what we want to do is get the values from Bricklink. So we're going to file and select all, or use the keyboard shortcuts Control A or Command A, depending on your operating system. Now that all the parts are highlighted, we want to use the dollar sign with a little Bricklink logo on the top toolbar. This will bring up a set to price guide window. We want to choose last 6 months sales and average, and then click OK. You'll get a confirmation message once this has been done, and you can see the price column has now got the price, and the total has got the total value of that lot. So you can see lot 3, the round plate 2x2, there are 4 items at 0.036, which gives us a total value of 0.143. And yes, if you weren't sure, Bricklink isn't a get rich quick scheme. At the top right of the screen, you can see the number of items and lots, the weight of the items, along with the total value. And if you find the price column with three decimal places all too much, you can right click on the price column and choose round price to two decimals. Clicking on a column sorts that column in descending or ascending order. In this case, if you click on the price column, you can see it gives us the most expensive part, the window from the Tide Bomber at the top at 76 cents. On the top right where the euro value is, you can click on the drop down and change the currency to US dollars, pound sterling, or any of the other currencies that Bricklink supports. The exchange rate is taken from the European Central Bank, or you can enter your own custom exchange rate. Just one tip, it's always worth saving the inventory file. I usually use the default file name, and it makes it easy to find the details should you need them again. Stage 4 of the process is using the information from Brickstore to directly access Bricklink data. So in this case, we're going to look at the window again. Right click. I've slowed this down for you. At the bottom, you can see Show Bricklink Price Guide Info. This takes us directly to the Bricklink dataset price guide for this item. Sometimes this data can be confusing because the currencies are consolidated, so we will use the button that says Group by Currency. Once we press this, we get the data by currency. So at the top here, we've got euros, and we can see that the average price in the last 6 months for the new part was 72 cents and the used was 34 cents. The look of the price guide page can be changed under settings and then my price guide settings. At the moment, my account anywhere. I can change it to the European Union, click on save settings, and then go back to the item I was looking at using the back arrow is one way of doing it. And then you'll need to refresh the data. Changing these settings gives us a long list of items that have been sold by European Union sellers across the world. And we can see their prices in euros. Euros are 72 cents for new, dollars, pounds, and various other currencies across the world. Get there in a minute. Dollars 94 cents for new. And further down, Australian dollars, pound sterling 46 pence for new. So you can see the variance in pricing across the world for sellers based in the EU. There's lots of information on this screen, depending on where you are and what you're interested in. If you go back up to the top, you can also go to settings. We can also go to settings and my price guide settings and change it to a specific country. This time we're going to change it to the United Kingdom. Using this drop down, choose United Kingdom, in country, save settings. And this time click on the back arrow, right click, and you can choose the page with the window on it, and then refresh. And here we have sellers is located in the United Kingdom, and we can see just data for those sellers. We can see the average price is 72 pence for new. US dollars 94 cents. Australian dollars 210 and pound sterling's 46. Okay, so lots and lots of data available using this method and this price guide screen. Just a quick interruption. If you've enjoyed the video, it'll be really helpful if you could give me a like. Okay, so if we go back to the settings again, sorry, I keep doing that. It's my Bricklink settings. My price guide settings, and this time we'll change the country to Spain, where I am. Make sure we save the settings, right click on that arrow and choose the item, refresh the screen to give us the data. We can see seller located in Spain, $0.72. And this is the current items that are available. You can see the average is 67 and the cheapest is 30. By hovering over the green square, we can see the shop, the store. And if we click on that green square, it actually takes us to the item in that seller's Bricklink store. So that's a quick way of seeing who's selling what and at what price. So in stage five, we're going to prepare the inventory that we've got for the tie bomber and get it ready to upload into Bricklink as if we're going to sell it. So the first thing I'm going to do is change the price of the window. I'm going to make it 72 cents. The remarks section is where you can record your storage details, whether or not that's a reference, a box, a bag, or the set number. It's up to you. Lots of different ways of doing it. I can do another video about my way another time. Now we're going to find the value of the tile 1x6, right click, choose Bricklink price guide. These are sellers in Spain, which is applicable to me. Average is 15 cents. Average is 15 cents. I've already got four. That gold box means that that's my store. I've got four of them at 12. I'm going to go back to my store, go back to Bricklink, and I'm going to make them 15 and record where they are in my inventory in one of my small drawers. Right click on this round brick. See, average price is 10. Currently it's 10. I've got four of them. They're at 10. I shall leave that at 10. And record where it is. This is going to be round one. My system sounds very complicated, doesn't it? Right click on this item. Average is 6 cents. Current average, 10 cents. I haven't got any. So for this, we're going to go with 6 cents and record it as around 2x2 brick. Around 2x2 will be fine. So do the plate as well. Right click, price, Bricklink price guide. You can see that I've got 25 at 6 cents. Average price is 8. Current average is 7. I'm going to leave this at 7. So without you having to watch, I'll quickly fill in the rest of the information. So now that the inventory file has got my price data and storage locations, I'm going to save the file again. And now we're ready to bring the inventory into Bricklink. So first off, Control A, Command A, or Select All to highlight all the items you want to export. So we can see all the items are blue. We go to File, Export. There are five choices here. We want Bricklink Mass Upload XML to Clipboard. Click on that. This opens a special window in Bricklink for us. We paste Control V, Command V, the data we've just copied, and verify the file. That gives us this list, shows us all the parts we're going to import, the items, the parts, and the total value. I'm not actually going to import this into my inventory, so I won't click the button because I want to use it for another video. Stage six is the last part. It's just a way of showing you how you can actually see how much the fallback sells for around the world. So from the main Bricklink page, enter the set number 911 911 613. You can see here the price guide grouped by currency and excluding incomplete. Check the settings to see what it's showing us. My brick guide settings. So we want this for anywhere in the world because we want to see the price everywhere. Save settings. Go back to where we were, the Tide Bomber foil pack. Refresh the settings. Group by currency, exclude incomplete. And now we can see what the item sold for in euros, 383. What it sold for in dollars, none have sold. Somebody's selling them for 995. In the UK, some of them have sold for 405. None in Norway, none in the Philippines. So for this particular foil pack, there's very limited sales across the world. there are only 154 new full bags for sale and 6 used ones. So at least on Bricklink, the supplies after 6 years are fairly limited. I've included some links to Amazon and eBay in the descriptions and pinned comments in case you're interested in having a look at those.